We're gonna be testing out the 08 150R. We're gonna see how this thing running, y'all. You know what I'm saying? See if we got that V-touch. I feel like 150s is one of the hardest bikes to tune, though. I'm not gonna lie, y'all. It's real hard to tune a 150. Especially how that bike not bogging too bad or, you know, idling perfect. Especially the older ones, like the 07s. 08 07 08. Whoa. Oh man, salt out on the plate, y'all. Yeah, y'all let me know what y'all think about the 150 though, man. Yeah, boy, stalled that on me, y'all. These copperheads get flooded too easy. Yeah, these copperhead bikes get flooded easier though, y'all. But y'all see it back to that idle though. Woo! One thing about it, boy, these copperhead, when you stall a lot, catwalking, you can flood the copperhead any kind of way. But y'all see what it's doing though. See back to idling good. Like it's the best it's gonna get right here though. That's the best tune it's gonna get. It's the best I can get the idle. The idle with the tune. Kill switch, everything still working right, you know what I'm saying? That's the best I can get the tune gain on this bike, y'all. I mean the tune, that's the best I can tune it to idle like perfect without idling too high and too rough. You know, the air screw and everything set up to the idle and the air screw, that's the best it's gonna get. If you mess with either one, this bike is gonna like idle too high or too low. So even with the response, it's not bogging like it was when he dropped it off when I test rided it. Y'all let me know. Y'all leave y'all feedback on it though. The 08 CRF 150. One thing I did notice though with this bike is that the front shocks is a little bouncy, y'all. As y'all can see, the front shocks go down way too easy. Yeah, the front shocks go down too easy, so his front shocks might be shot, might be bad, y'all. But most likely is bad because it's going down too easy, you know what I'm saying? But the back shock is it's still pretty decent, you know what I'm saying? Back shock's still pretty decent, but I feel like that could be stronger too. The back shock can be a little more stronger. He got it adjusted all the way up. Oh yeah, he got it adjusted. That's why I sit so tall in the back. He got the screw adjusted all the way down, y'all. So it lift the bike all the way up. But like I told y'all, man, One thing, like I told y'all, if I was him, I would change the chain out. Because the chain is a little rusty. But I just went ahead and tightened it up for him a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Just to be safe. But back brakes feel pretty good, y'all. But yeah, y'all let me know. Y'all leave a comment. Let me know what y'all think. The 150. See, it got a nice idle. Sometimes with these 150s, you have to hit the gas a little bit sometimes for it to start up. Yeah, these 150s, they be tricky with starting sometimes. You gotta hit the gas a little bit and it'll start up. But after it start up, it's gonna idle perfect. As y'all can see. Yeah, sometimes you'll have to hit the gas a little bit when it starts. Y'all, I'm just gonna show y'all real quick. Yeah, I'm gonna do it without the gas. See? Still crank up without the gas. You know what I'm saying? But sometimes you'll have to give it a little gas and then still start. But yeah, man. Y'all let me know what y'all think. the best tune with this bike that this bike gonna get, y'all. It still got that nice idle. No leaks, no nothing. No oil leaks. I'll let you know what y'all think. Actually like 150 though. They feel real good, especially when it's tuned right. But yeah, other than that, y'all already know the vibe, man. Y'all already know, get in and get a cycle, South Florida vibe. V-Touch Real, we gonna go from there.